Hello and welcome to Wisdom Trek. This is Guthrie Chamberlain and I'm your guide to wisdom and creating a living legacy. Thank you for joining us for our 7 day a week, 7 minutes of wisdom podcast. This is day 192 of our trek, and yesterday we climbed and conquered Alibi Mountain as we bypassed all of the If Only rabbit trails. Today we're going to hike the Ink It Trail, where we will learn how to ink it when you think it. If you miss any of our days of the Wisdom Trek episodes, please go to wisdom-trek.com to listen to them and to read our daily journal. We are recording our podcast from our studios at Home 2 in Charlotte, North Carolina. What a great time to be alive. Just to think that through our computers, we can communicate with anyone all over the world nearly instantaneously. The adoption of the internet worldwide, and especially mobile technology, is growing so rapidly. We must not overlook the opportunities that will allow us to impact others. One area that I'll be pursuing going into 2016 is to establish a community of podcasters that are Christ followers to provide them with a platform of services and support. This will be called the Christian Podcasting Network, and if you are interested in receiving additional information about it when we roll it out, please email me at guthrie@venturecg.com and I'll keep you informed of the progress. The impact that we can have in the faith community has a tremendous potential worldwide. One word of caution though, with so much information online, we can become easily overloaded with more information than we can effectively process if we are not careful. That is why we must put into place systems to capture those great ideas so that we can implement them when the time is right. We can't possibly act on all of our ideas, so capturing them is essential. On today's trek, I want to dig up some nuggets of wisdom that I discovered from Laura Stack, who refers to herself as the Productivity Pro. Playing off her terminology, our hike today will be along the Ink It Trail. On our hike today, we will learn one of the best ways of increasing productivity. If you think it, ink it. John Steinbeck said this, "Ideas are like rabbits. You get a couple of them and learn how to handle them, and pretty soon you'll have a dozen." Laura Stack's father had a saying that he used and repeated often. He always carried around one of those little Mead spiral notebooks in his pocket, which he liked to call his brain. And whenever an idea would strike him, he'd write it down and say, "If you think it, ink it." Now, Laura's dad was correct. You can't depend on your brain to remember everything, especially when you're in the middle of another task. Nor is it a good idea to drop that task that you're working on and go wandering off after this new idea. Oh, you can do that, but if you make it a habit of it, you'll never finish anything, and you'll waste hours in your day. No wonder so many people feel like they're ADHD with sensory overload today. It's so easy to get distracted. So when you do have a random thought that sounds good, get it down on paper or electrons as soon as possible. You can use a little notebook, a handheld device like a smartphone, a compact voice recorder, 3x5 index cards, or a standardized planner. Whatever works for you is what you should use. Now, I personally use Evernote, which is loaded on my phone, my tablet, and all my computers because it syncs the exact same information everywhere. For about a year before I started the Wisdom Trek podcast, I started compiling a list of topics for my daily episodes. My list contains nearly 300 topics, with more being added as I check off the ones that I've already completed. This is all handled within Evernote, so no matter what I'm doing or where I am, I can record an idea or clip an article and then put it into Evernote. This allows me to ink it when I think it. Then my brain is available to continue working at the task on hand, and I don't have to be concerned that I'll remember it later. This next section is called Fishing for Ideas. It's been said that ideas are like slippery little fish that you have to capture with your pencil or else they get away. As the saying goes, even the dullest pencil or pixel in the electronic device is keener than the sharpest mind. So capture your great ideas however you may, and then get right back to your original task. Another great thing about recording your ideas, your brain will think that you've done something about it and stop bugging you so that you can focus on what you're doing. Even if your idea is a non-bugging kind, if you write it down, you don't have to waste any energy trying to remember it later. It's all recorded in black and white. By inking it, you've made it real. And oddly enough, when you write down your ideas, it seems to make you have more of them. That may simply be a function of the fact that you don't have to remember them all when you record them, but it also could be attributed to God's divine guidance in our lives, allowing our creativity to blossom. Think about how Jesus took a few loaves and fish. When he broke them down, they became so much more. Matthew chapter 15, verse 36 and 37. Then he took the 7 loaves and the fish, thanked God for them, and broke them into pieces. And he gave them to his disciples, who distributed the food to the crowd, and they all ate as much as they wanted. Afterwards, the disciples picked up 7 large baskets full of leftover food. By the time you review your notes, you may have forgotten the ideas altogether, so you may be pleasantly surprised by what you find. And what do you end up with when you're done? Why, a little list of things to do. Now, why doesn't that sound familiar? Yep, you got it. Your ideas, or at least the best of them, can end up on your to-do list so that you can focus your attention on them properly. And if you come up with another brilliant idea while you're working on your new task, well, if you think it, ink it. The next section I'll entitle From Fish to Seeds. Now, I've compared the ideas to slippery fish, which you have to capture, but once you've done that, they turn into something else. And I'm not talking about fish sticks here. These ideas you've stuck with, whether while working on something else, during your daily commute, or in the middle of the night, become seeds once you gather them in. Now, they may never germinate, of course, and even if they are viable, you may never use them. You can't do everything that you imagine because there just isn't enough time. But if you carry those little seeds around with you, sort of like Johnny Appleseed, you may very well come across some fertile soil which they can sprout in. That's when you have to plant them in the ground and stand back so you can see what will become of them. This reminds me of the principle of planting and harvesting that is found in 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 6. Remember this, a farmer who plants only a few seeds will get only a small crop, but the one who plants generously will get a generous crop. So plant a generous crop of ideas. Ideas are important for everyone, even the most daring and ambitious of undertakings, such as the Great Wall of China or the International Space Station, started out as nothing more than an idea that someone eventually recorded. Once they did that, it went from meditation to action and changed the world. So on your trek of the Ink It Trail, make it a habit when you think it, then ink all of your ideas. Don't judge them, just record them. Then later, when you do have time, you can keep the good ones and take action on them, and set aside the other ones that are not feasible, at least for this season of life. Each day, think of ways to impact your world. And one of those ways is to share Wisdom Trek with your family and friends and encourage them to join us each day, and then come along yourself tomorrow for another day of Wisdom Trek, Creating a Legacy, where we will explore how to collect the dots and then connect the dots. That will finish our podcast for today. Remember to listen to your daily dose of wisdom each day at wisdom-trek.com, or you can subscribe at iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher, SoundCloud, and many of the other social media platforms. And please share Wisdom Trek with your family and friends through email, Facebook, Twitter, or in person as you meet with them, and invite them to come along with us each day. If you'd like to be added to our weekly email updates or special publications from Wisdom Trek, just text the word WISDOM to 44222 on your phone, and you'll receive a message asking you for your email address. It's very quick and easy to do, and our emails are very limited. The journal for today's trek can be found at wisdom-trek.com. Thank you for allowing me to be your guide, your mentor. But most importantly, I do consider you my friend as I serve you through the Wisdom Trek podcast and journal each day. As we take this trek together, let us always live abundantly, love unconditionally, listen intentionally, learn continuously, lend to others generously, lead with integrity, and leave a living legacy each day. This is Guthrie Chamberlain reminding you to keep moving forward, enjoy your journey, and then create a great day every day. See you tomorrow.